AGF, the online platform for GATE Agriculture Engineering. And this is all about me. Now friends, today we are going to discuss the different parameters present in the pump with their relationship with discharge and head and speed and power. So first of all, we will see the relationship between the discharge and speed of running speed of pump, that is RPM. Friends, the discharge is directly proportional to the running speed of pump. Means, if we increase the value of discharge, then the running speed of pump increase linearly. Means, friends, here the relationship is linear relationship. Means, agar hum pump ke discharge ko double karenge, to uska linear speed bhi double hoga. हाँ, you see that Q2 by Q1 is equal to N2 by N1. Means, if the discharge is double, then the running speed is also double. Now, the second one, that is pressure head and the running speed. The pressure head is proportional to the square of running speed. Means, if the running speed is double, then the pressure head will become 4 times because it is square. And the third one is the power, that is directly proportional to the running speed to the power 3. Means, if the running speed is double, then the power is going to be 8 times. So friends, this is the, you can see that and you can easily understand the terms. And friends, this is the another relationship, that is in terms of, here you see that it is the relationship is in terms of running speed. Means running speed, that is N2, N1, these are running speeds of pump. But here you see the relationship between the diameter of pump. So in is the first one, that is Q1 by Q2 is equal to D1 by D2. That is direct linear relationship as like previous one. And second one is the pressure relationship with the diameter of impeller. So it is also like previous one, only it is the square relationship. That is, if we increase the diameter of impeller 2 times, then the pressure head increase by 4 times. And the third one is BHP, means brake horsepower. If we increase the diameter 2 times, then the brake horsepower will increase 8 times. Friends, see that these both relationships are almost same, means almost equivalent. So there is nothing change in these relationships. Friends, one thing I will tell you here, that you see the relationship with pump speed. You can apply it anywhere in agriculture. In any questions has come regarding pump or nozzle or a sprayer, regarding anything the questions will come, you can directly apply this formula, means this relationship. It is valid everywhere. Means whatever questions, suppose questions are coming on fan, questions are coming on pump, questions are coming on sprayer, you can easily apply everywhere this formula, means these three relationships. ये तीनों relationship आप agriculture में जितने भी questions हैं, इस type के relationship based, वो चाहे वो pump के based, pump में हो, या फिर fan में हो, या फिर sprayer में हो, वो आप तीनों जगहों पे apply कर सकते हो. But friends, this is not with the second one. This relationship is only applied in pump. You remember that this diameter relationship is only applied in pump. You can't apply this relationship in sprayers and fans, because there another relationship I will tell in another video, that the relationship with sprayer and nozzles like that, that is another relationship. But this is only applied in pump. That's my motto to understand, to tell these both things simultaneously, that the first one, it is applied everywhere. Whatever questions are coming with this relationship, like speed of pump and discharge, and means related to speed, you can apply everywhere. But when the questions are coming on diameter, you can apply it only in case of impellers, means in case of pumps. Apart from pump, you can't put this relationship. Otherwise, your answers will be definitely wrong. So, aapko ye केवल एंड केवल पंप के केस में अप्लाई करना है ये डायमीटर वाली रिलेशनशिप। अगर क्वेश्चन स्प्रेयर का है या फिर नोजल का है या फिर फैन का है तो आपको ये अप्लाई नहीं करनी है, उसकी अलग रिलेशनशिप है जो कि मैं आने वाली वीडियोस में बताऊंगा। नाउ फ्रेंड्स कमिंग टू द क्वेश्चंस, यू सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट इज आस्क्ड इन 2003। हियर द स्प्रिंकलर इज गिवन एंड द टू नोजल्स ऑफ स्प्रिंकलर्स आर गिवन एंड इट इज गिवन दैट डिस्चार्ज इज गिवन एंड द प्रेशर्स आर गिवन, द टू प्रेशर्स आर गिवन दैट इज 290 एंड 262 एंड इट इज सिंपली आस्किंग द सेकेंड डिस्चार्ज दैट इज Q2 वैल्यू एंड यू कैन सिंपली सी द रिलेशनशिप। यू सी हियर दैट Q2 बाई Q1 इज इक्वल इट इज आई थिंक प्रेशर रिलेशनशिप, सो यू सी दिस इज द प्रेशर हेड दैट इज H2 बाई H1 इज इक्वल टू N2 बाई N1। And friends, see that N2 by N1 is directly proportional to Q2 by Q1. From here, we can conclude that H2 by H1 is directly proportional to the square of Q2 by Q1. Means here it is not given the speed, but it is given the discharge. And we know that speed is directly proportional to discharge. That's why we simply put the speed value in place of discharge, and we can get the answer. फ्रेंड्स यहाँ पे एक बार ध्यान से आप देखो, यहाँ पे जो हेड है H2 by H1 वो है N2 by N1 to the power whole square, means N2 by N1 के whole square के equivalent है and N2 by N1 है वो directly proportional है हमारे discharge Q2 by Q1 के। So यहाँ से हम conclude कर सकते हैं, we can conclude that H2 by H1 is proportional to the square of Q2 by Q1. एंड सिमिलरली प्रेशर के लिए भी हम कंक्लूड कर सकते हैं कि P2 बाई P1 इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू द Q2 बाई Q1 टू द होल पावर 3। मीन्स यहां से हम लोग एक डिराइवेशन भी निकाल सकते हैं डिस्चार्ज और हेड का और पावर और डिस्चार्ज का, मीन्स यहां से कंक्लूजन निकाल सकते हैं। सो हियर यू सी इट इज वेरी सिंपल एंड यू कैन गेट द आंसर। नाउ सी अनदर क्वेश्चन विच इज आस्क्ड इन the year 2001, here the head it is H2 it is asking and N2 and N1 are given, so you can simply put the values and you can get the answer that is 65.3. Friends, that is another question asked in 1988. Friends, this question is looking very lengthy and difficult, but it is very easy, so you read it carefully. Here the impeller diameter is given that is 35 centimeter and delivers 3 meter cube per minute of air static pressure at 5 centimeter of water with a speed of 500 rpm and power input of 4.5 kilowatt. The speed and static pressure if the same fan is made to deliver 4.5 meter cube. Means friends, here Q2 and Q1 values are given and it is asking the speed and static pressure. Means Q2 and Q1 values are given in the question. You see that Q2 value is 4.5 meter cube per minute and Q1 value is 3 meter cube per minute. So you see here the linear relationship with speed, that is N2 by N1 is equal to Q2 by Q1. So from there you can calculate the N2 value, that is 750 rpm. After that you know that head is proportional to the square of speed. So use the relationship, that is H2 by H1 is equal to N2 square by N1 square. From there you can get the H2 value, that is 11.25 centimeter of water. Now friends, coming to the next question. In second part it is asking the percentage increase in power to run the fan at its increased speed. Means it is saying that what is the percentage increase in power. So you have the N1 value, you have the N2 value. Now you simply put the P2 by P1 is equal to N2 cube by N1 cube. And from there you can calculate the P2 value. That is, you see that the P1 value is given, that is 4.5 kilowatt. And you can get the relationship and you can calculate the P2 value by using the relationship. And you can get the answer, that is 237.5%. Here I have not calculated the P2 value. Here simply I have replaced the P2 value by its linear relationship with P1, and P1, P1 cancel, and I can get the answer. Now friends, see the third portion, that is, any fan of size 4.5 meter cube per minute is delivered is not allowed to deviate from 500 RPM. Friends, in the third part, it is saying that a new fan is coming, that is delivering at 4.5 meter cube and its speed is 500 RPM. So you have to see here, I told you initially only that the diameter formula is not applicable in case of fans and in case of nozzle of sprayers. That is only applicable in case of the pump. So friends, here you see that it is the case of fan. So you can't apply the formula in the, you can't apply this relationship of diameter in this question. So you have to read the fan relationship so that you can solve such type of questions. Friends, you remember that the discharge of fan is directly proportional to the cube of its diameter. Means this is the relationship of fan discharge with its diameter. So I have simply put all the values, that is D2 cube by D1 cube is equal to Q2 by Q1, and I can get the value of D2, that is 0.4 meter. Now friends, coming to the next question, that is coming in 1989. How many times the power requirement of centrifugal fan increased when its speed is increased by 100%? I think all of you know that P is directly proportional to the NQ, means power is directly proportional to the speed Q. So here the speed is increased two times, means 100% it is saying. Initially the speed is, suppose initially the speed is 100, after it's increased by 100%, its speed become 200. So you can get the 2 to the power 3, that is 8, the answer. Now coming to the next question, it has given, a centrifugal pump is delivers 1200 liters per minute of water against a head of 10 meter and requires 5 HP when running at 100,000 RPM. Find the discharge and horsepower of pump to run at 1500 RPM. So you first calculate the head of pump. Here you see that its head is given, that is 10 meter. Means the head, it is saying that the head is, means constant, head is not vary. It is given 10 meter and requires 5 HP of power. And it is asking find the discharge and horsepower if the pump is running at 1500 RPM. Means initial RPM is 1000 and final RPM is 1500. And it is asking the discharge and horsepower. So you all know that the horsepower is proportional to the speed to the power 3. Means to the if we increase the speed by double, means by 2 times, then the horsepower will increase by 8 times. So I have simply done the relationship and multiply by 5, because HP1 initial the horsepower is given 5 HP. So I have got the answer, that is 16.875. And in the second portion, that is very easy, discharge, you all know that it is directly proportional to the speed of the pump. So simple is a linear relationship and you can get the answer, that is 1800. Now coming to the next question asked in 2014, it is given that the impeller diameter is 200 mm and the power is 1.86. And the impeller is replaced by another impeller, that is 180 mm diameter, and brake power it is asking. And friends, you all know that brake power is directly proportional to the speed to the power 3, means speed to the power Q. So you simply use the relationship that here I have marked, means circle the relationship which is used. You see this relationship, BHP 1 divided by BHP 2 is equal to D1 by D2 to the power whole cube. So you simply put 180. 180 is the final. 180 is the final diameter, and 200 is the initial diameter. Whole to the power 3 is equal to BHP by means P by. I have assumed here power as P. P by 1.86. That the answer I have got, that is 1.36. And coming to the next question, here it is given that efficiency is 75% requires 6 kilowatt power at 1450 rpm against a static head of 5 meter and delivery head of 12 meter and a pump run at 1650 rpm, frictional head is negligible. Find the friends here in the, you see that in the questions there are so many things are written. These things are written only to confuse you. So you don't have to confuse that the question is very large and very lengthy. So its solution may be very lengthy. But it's not true. The solutions are easy. So the question is given lengthy only to confuse you. So you don't be confused and take your motivation and be confident from inside that I can solve the question. Then only you can attempt the question with a positive approach. So you see here that the head is given, that is suction head is given and the delivery head is given. Suction head is 5 meter and the delivery head is 12 meter. Friends, I think all of you have studied the pump, you know that total head is equal to suction head plus delivery head. So you add both these head, 5 plus 12 is equal to 17 meters, that is the total head. And friends, the relationship which I have told with head and pressure and the discharge, that is the total head, total pressure and total discharge relationship. Not the partially pressure or partial head or partial discharge, not like that. That is for total of the pump. So you first calculate the total head, that is 17. And after that, it is given that the initial speed is given, that is 1450, and final speed is given, that is 1680 rpm. Means N1 and N2 values are given in the question, and you can simply use, you all know that head is directly proportional to the speed to the power 2, means directly proportional to N to the power 2. So you can simply use that relationship and you can get the H value, that is 22.01 meters. That is the first option. Now friends, see the question which is asked in GATE 2010 paper. Friends, by seeing this question, it is looking very difficult and very lengthy, but genuinely it is very easy question. So you read the question. Here it is given that discharge is given, that is 3200 liters per minute, and flow head, total head is given, that is 60 meter, and the impeller diameter is given, that is 0.26, and it is rotated at 1800 rpm. After that, the motor output shaft 54 meter is required to drive the pump. The existing irrigation motor and the such a way that pump requires it to reduce to. And friends, here you see that when it is rotated by the motor, then its discharge pressure is reduced to 52 meter. Means initial head is given, initial pressure is given, that is 60 meter. And after some time when it is motorized, then the pressure reduces to 52 meter while keeping the flow rate constant. Friends, here you see that while keeping, means flow rate is constant, means the Q value is constant. No change in Q value, only changing in the head value, that is pressure value, H value. So now to meet the new system requirement, the impeller diameter. So it is initially it is given the head value, H1, H and H2 values are given in the question, and D1 value is given, that is 0.26 meter diameter is given, and it is asking to meet the new requirement, what should be the diameter of the impeller, means D2 value it is asking. So you can simply use the relationship with pressure and diameter, that is pressure is directly proportional to the diameter to the power 2, means diameter ka square hoga pressure. So yahan pe initial pressure hai 50, initial pressure hai 60 and final pressure hai 52, means 52 by 60 is equal to, assume that the final diameter is d by 0.26 and pressure ka power hoga 0.5, means 1/2. Suppose diameter ka power hai 2, then agar reverse, if we are going reverse, then pressure ka power ho jayega 1/2. 0.2. Coming to the next concept, which is based upon the specific speed of pump. Friends, you all, I think all of you must probably know the relationship, that is NS means specific speed of pump is equal to N into root under Q divided by H to the power 3 by 4. Friends, here you remember that all the units are in SI unit and the N value is in RPM, means NS value, that is a specific speed and operational speed value is in RPM, remaining the discharge is in meter cube per second and head is in meter. But friends, here note that the head is the head, not the total head of pump, that is the head per stage, means pumps consist of different stages. Suppose many times it are given that 3 stage pump or 6 stage pump, like that it is given and total head is given, then you have to divide the total head by the number of heads, means you have to calculate the head per stage, you don't simply use that total head. So only this thing is important in this concept. So you see the first question asked in 2003, that is, it is simply rotating pump that is 1440 RPM and the operating at 30 meter operating head, means H value is given, that is 30, and the specific speed is given and it is asking the discharge. So you simply put the NS value is 160, N value is 1440, and you have to calculate the Q value, that is 2.029 meter cube per second. Now see the next question. It is given that 1450 is the N value is given, that is operational speed is given, and 20 liters per second of discharge is given and 30 meter is the total head. So you have to calculate the NS value, means specific speed value. So you simply put in the relationship and you can get the answer. Friends, here see that the discharge is given in 20 liters per second. So it is given in liters. So you have to convert it into meter cube per second. Means you have to divide it by 1000. And friends, you remember one thing. Whenever you are, if you are going to, it is not very lengthy, so you are going to confuse. But in case, by chance you are confused by such type of questions, that which value is the specific speed value and which value is the operational speed value, then you simply remember that your specific speed value, means NS value, should always be less than the N value. Means this is one logic you can use, that whatever your answer is coming is always less than the given RPM. Means suppose the operational speed of pump is given, that is 1450 RPM here given, and it is asking you to calculate the specific speed of pump. So a specific speed is always less than this operational speed value. Now see the next question. It is given that the operating speed is 1450 and the discharge is 25 liters per second. And if the operating speed is 1600 RPM, then the operating head. It is, you see in this, friends, you see this question. It is saying that the motor operating speed is 1560 revolution per minute and the operating head is 18 meter. And it is asking the what is the specific speed of centrifugal pump. It is not directly asking, it is just only asking the relationship. So you see that 1560 revolution per minute, so you convert it into second, means divided by 60, and remaining things as it is, you put that in meter, means meter second, here units are given, and you put the values, you can get the answer, that is 0.83. Now see the next question. It is asked in this year paper. Here it is also very simple question in 2020 paper, that discharge is given, that is 15 liters, base point efficiency, total head 25 meter, and the specific speed of pump is asking in two digit in RPM in up to two digits of decimal. So friends, I have left this question so that you people can solve. And if you are, I think very easy question, and you are able to solve this by using the previous formula. Here it is asking the NS value, it is asking, and you have to put the formula, that is N means 1800 into root 0.05, because here the discharge is given in 50 liters per second, so convert it into meter cube per second, that is 0.05, and the head is given, that is 25 meter, so h to the power 3 by 2, you apply the formula, you can get the value, that is 36 RPM, you can get the answer. And friends, you see that in questions many times it is given that write up to two places of decimal. These things are only given to confuse you, so that you can get the confused in the examination, and you can write the means wrong answer. Here you see that the value is an integer, the answer is coming is integer, but it has written that you have to write up to two places of decimals. So don't be confused that it is written up to decimal means I have to write in decimal. You be confident about your formula and your concept, and you can solve by your concept. You can definitely get the right answer. Friends, see the next question which is asked in 2017 paper. Here the centrifugal pump delivers 120 liter per second and total head is 510 and design discharge is 1450 RPM, and it is asking the specific speed. Here the also the question is same. Only one thing, friends, you have to take care that here read the question, that is a 6-stage centrifugal pump. Is 6-stage. I have told you initially only that the head is H is the head per stage. Here it is a 6-stage pump, and it is given that total head is 510 meter. Means total head यहाँ पे 510 meter दिया हुआ है. But the जो हमारा pump है वो 6-stage pump है. और हम इसलिए हमें पहले तो amount of head per stage calculate करना पड़ेगा. That is 510 divided by 6 means 85 meter is the head per stage, that is the H value, and the discharge is given, that is 120 liter per second, so you convert it into meter cube per second, and then after you put the formula, that is NC is equal to N cube to the power 1 by 2 divided by H to the power 0.75, and you can get the answer, that is 17.94 RPM. Now see the next question which is asked in 2009 paper. It is simply said that 2400 liter per minute of total head of 36 meter, and it is connected, it is revolving at 440 revolution per minute, and its specific speed will be what? Friends, here also you see that the first thing you see that it is a 3-stage centrifugal pump is given. Means it is a 3-stage, and the total head is given, that is 36 meters. So the first thing you should do that convert it into head per stage, that is 36 by 3, that is 12 meter, and after that you put the Q value is discharge value in meter cube per second, and remaining things are very easy. I think all of you can do this, and the answer you can get, that is 44.67. So friends, this is the first part of pumps and wells, and after that we will make 2-3 parts of this portion so that we can cover the entire portion. And friends, please subscribe and like and share our channel so that we can get motivation and we will make further videos.